Yes, my name is Les Harmon. I am an associate professor here at the School of Nursing, and I'm the director of the HIV specialty for nurse practitioners.
So I'm Kara McGee. I'm a physician assistant, and I'm a clinical instructor here at the School of Nursing. And I help teach some of the courses in the HIV concentration and also precept students in clinicals.
I think one thing that really sets us apart as a school offering a concentration or a specialty in HIV is that we're the only distance-based program in the U.S. that's doing that. So we're able to take students from across the country.
I think one of the things that we tend to focus on in this concentration is making sure that students understand the comprehensive approach to people living with HIV. So yes, we teach the medical aspects of how to manage, diagnose, and manage HIV, but we also talk a lot about some of the psychosocial issues related to HIV infection that in fact can affect our patients' health.
There is a gap in the HIV provider workforce. Many of us who went to work in the field of HIV in the late 1980s, for example, are getting older, people are retiring, they're slowing down, and not as many people are coming into the field. So there's a pretty significant gap in providers, a provider shortage. So we're trying to address that with our program here. The current projections are that by 2020, about 70% of people with HIV infection will be over 50 years old. So people are living longer and they're living better lives, but as people with HIV grow older, they of course have other chronic health issues. So there's a need for people who work in HIV to have a good handle on general primary care and the management of other chronic illnesses. There's also a need for people in primary care to understand HIV as it becomes a more manageable chronic illness that will eventually migrate into the primary care setting. HIV is a highly stigmatized disease, and so not everybody is cut out to go into this type of work. So we're really looking for people who have a willingness and an interest in working with marginalized populations, people who are living with a highly stigmatized disease. We're looking for people who have an interest in public health. We're looking for people who enjoy working in settings that provide care to people who are from low-resource settings. Another aspect of our program here is, although we offer a specialty for people who want to go to work specifically in HIV, we're also trying to integrate HIV more intentionally in our curriculum so that all of our nurse practitioner students here have a good understanding of how to screen for HIV, how to diagnose HIV, how to link people to care so that they can get the medications they need. So another way that we're addressing the HIV provider shortage in the workforce is by offering our HIV specialty to nurse practitioners who are already out there working in primary care settings who would like to expand their skill set and learn more about HIV. They can come complete our 12-credit HIV specialty for a certificate in HIV primary care.
I've been doing this for a number of years, and one of the things that I often notice is that there's really a lack of providers who are knowledgeable in HIV management, but also who are knowledgeable about some of the challenges that people living with HIV face. And so I think the more people and health providers we can train to understand those issues, the better job we'll do of diagnosing HIV, starting people on treatment, and then over the long term keeping them engaged in care so that not only do they help their own health, but again they stay on medication, and which will help with prevention efforts. So thus far we have 21 graduates from the HIV concentration here at the Duke School of Nursing. That's something we're very proud of. The majority of those practitioners are also working in HIV specialty settings, which is very encouraging to us. They're also scattered around the country, so impacting different parts of our country. And all of so far we've had students trained in 19 different clinical settings across 9 states. And so I think that's, again, one of the things that perhaps makes our program unique.
So we do offer informational webinars on our program through the School of Nursing on a quarterly basis. So if you'd like some more information, you can register for one of our webinars. You can also contact me directly